Hello, Namaste, Salaam Walaikum, Sasriyakal. Welcome back to another session with your Washef at Vareva.com. Today I'm going to make nice egg sandwich, but whenever I have a sandwich, I need to have a milkshake or kind of a lassi. Because I'm Indian, I would prefer lassi. So for this, I'm going to use yogurt. In this yogurt, I'm going to sweeten this yogurt with, of course, fresh mangoes, but also the sugar what I'm going to use is also very important. You know, here I've got cane sugar. This is not like jaggery. This is cane sugar. This doesn't have many additives. Add some cane sugar to this and also, you know, cut the ripest mangoes possible. You know, the sugar has a different kind of taste. This sugar has kind of sugarcane flavor. So I want that along with my mangoes. And also, you can put some ice cubes and make a nice lassi. And I'm going to show you how to make the simple egg sandwich. For any sandwich, all you need is a good sandwich bread. Make sure you get the fresh, softest bread. And when I used to work in the 5-star hotel, they used to bake the bread fresh and they used to, you know, rest it, and then they used to cut this awesome sandwich. Itself is tasty because of the bread. And on this, we're going to use butter, spread the butter, and now we're going to turn it to the other side, because the other side you're going to put some mayonnaise and butter. So first I'm going to show you. So this is the butter that is left over. In this I'm going to use some mayo. In this add a little bit of mixed herb and some green chilies. Finely chopped green chilies. This will give very nice taste. Egg and pepper is a great combination, but with this I want that fresh chili flavor. Turn the breads to the other side. Now on this mayo and butter with green chilies, little bit of herbs, that will make this taste really good. Don't worry, you know, later it will look good. In this you can use any kind of vegetables. So today I'm going to use some boiled potatoes. Just, you know, I boil the potatoes and cut them round. These are looking little bit like pasta rounds, but you know, this is nothing but boiled potatoes, and then I just cut them round like this. And on this we're going to use some onions. But remember one thing, the finer they are, the tastier they get. A lot of people, what they do is, they do a big mistake of, you know, making those thick vegetables. No. See, the thinner you make, you can add different kinds of vegetables. So look at this. I've got onions. You don't have to worry anything. And on this, I'm going to do the same thing. Take a slicer. I did not cut it with the knife myself. Slice them thin with the slicer. Now, on this, we're going to put the eggs. Eggs also, make them thin slices. Look at them. Perfect. This egg will have a little bit of flavor. Putting a little bit of crushed pepper, you will get a very refreshing flavor. And also, I'm going to sprinkle a little bit of salt. I'm going to add cheese to it. But still, my vegetables little bit, not too much, just a little bit. On this, you're going to put the cheese. Okay? The cheese will go on even on the edges. A lot of people use cheese slices, but I'm going to use simple grated cheese on top. Okay? You know, in the some nice flavor with some chopped coriander. And other side of the thing, again we're going to put this mayo spread. This is, you know, you may think that I'm adding a lot of mayonnaise, but this is what keeps your nice sandwich nice and juicy. When you eat, the bread won't be sticking in your mouth. So this is what it is. Now look at this. All you need to do is just press it. I know there is butter on this side. Just take like this and press it. I've got the nice tawa with the grill marks. So I'm going to grill this on this tawa. So just take spatula kind of thing. You know, just press it little bit. Cheese inside, everything will have. The butter, whatever we put, will slightly melt and also will give those nice grill marks. You know, the other side is nicely colored very carefully. So how do you turn? You can't just turn it into the on that. So just put it on this, and again we're going to very carefully. See, simple techniques will make your life very, very easy. Put it the other side, and now you got these nice grill marks. These grill marks will give you very crunchy for the bite. So you will thoroughly enjoy. So look at this, perfect. And we're going to let it cook on the other side too. Now you have this sandwich absolutely perfectly ready. And also, you know, you learn certain things from the guest also. So one time, one crazy guest, he says he doesn't want the lines straight like this. They need to go across the bread. That's when you will get the real crunch. Cutting is also, we just put the knife there and put these fingers to hold it. Just cut. Look at this bread. perfect and super. The sandwich is all ready and hot. I'm going to make a, this is like nice thick lassi with a cane sugar rim along with this, and all you need is a little bit ketchup. Any sandwich, I want ketchup. Sandwiches are also my comfort food. You know, when you want to eat light, this is the best thing to have. Looking at this sandwich, it reminds me of the club sandwich I used to enjoy when I used to work in ITC Welcome Group Maurya Sheraton in Delhi. And after that, nowhere else I get that kind of awesome club sandwich, and the same sandwich I can get anywhere is in my house. I'm going to show you how to make that sandwich also. But anytime a sandwich needs a good drink, and that too, summer's mango. With the cane sugar on the rim, it is wow. This is mango lassi, seem to have got better and better with this cane sugar. Many times I stop on the roadside also to buy the fresh chips while they are frying and enjoy. But time to enjoy the sandwich. After you take a bite, a little bit dip of tomato ketchup. Best sandwich at home. Summers, I'm sweating a lot, but with a mango lassi. Mmm.